The storm is coming. The scent of war swirls in the air. The Imperial throne lies empty, and three great alliances fight to claim it. Evil awakens. A long-vanished foe stirs. Those who would destroy Tamriel seek out dangers to their dark plot. And so death's long arm reaches out. It is the 582nd year of the Second Era. The drums of war are sounding. This is where our journey begins.
Thank you. Are you all right? The name's Lyris. I hope you've still got some fight left in you. You're going to need it.
To the litter. Keep your weapon ready and stay sharp. This place is full of surprises. Keep moving. There are more Daedra on the way. Let's keep moving.
Don't stop now. Keep moving. More guards are on the way.
Thank you.
Let's get out of here, my friend. The Prophet.
Greetings, Vestige.
Like you, I am a prisoner in this place. You must rescue me, and I, in turn, must rescue you.
Hold a moment. Come here. We need to talk. The Prophet. He's a prisoner here, too. It was very dangerous for him to speak to you, even for a moment. You must think you can help me. Break him out, of course. Believe me, I can use all the help I can get. That blind old man is the only person alive who can help us get back home. Tamriel's a long way from here. These tunnels will eventually take us to the Towers of Eyes. That's where we'll find the Sentinels. Magical constructs created by Molag Bal to guide his vision in Cold Harbor. The Sentinels are connected. If we destroy one, the others will be blinded. With any luck, that will buy us the time we need to free the Prophet. I've no idea. Brute force? We'll find a way. We have to. Be ready for anything. I doubt Molag Bal left the Sentinels unguarded. I'm sure you do. And I'll answer them as best I can. He's a strange one, no doubt about it. But he's the wisest man I've ever met. He sees things. Past, future. You're obviously not in Tamriel anymore. Think of the most miserable, depressing place you've ever been in your life. That's paradise compared to Cold Harbor. And to top it off, well, there's no easy way to say it. You're dead. I don't know. Once we rescue the Prophet, he can tell you about the gods and the ways of Oblivion. I don't understand any of it myself. A man named Menemarco. His worm cult is doing some kind of ritual back in Tamriel. They sacrificed you and everyone in this prison to the Daedric Prince Molag Bal. After you died, whatever was left showed up here. They call you the Soul Shriven. It means you're a slave and you'll spend the rest of eternity here in Cold Harbor, working under the lash of the Daedra. Unless, of course, you come with me. No, I wasn't sacrificed. The Prophet and I were brought here conventionally, if that makes any sense. But we're prisoners here, same as you. It won't be easy. The place is watched by magical constructs called Sentinels. We won't stand a chance unless we can blind them. I'll tell you more when we get there. And we'll never get there if we don't get moving. We should keep moving. Well played, friend. Marquis Beard, you are good in a fight.
The god of brutality knows of your escape. Hurry!
The god of schemes can see every part of Cold Harbor. We need to distract him. Name again? Target practice? Sentinels are connected. If we destroy one, the others will also be... One to fight. The god of self-punishment? been a fair fight. If there were three of you.
Blinded, we must get to the Prophet's cell.
You will never escape my realm.
Hermamora's wagging tongue. The door's warded. We'll never get in this way. Damn it. Destroying the Sentinel must have triggered these wards. We'll need to find another way in. Maybe Cadwell can help us. Cadwell is the oldest of the Soul Shriven. After years of torment, Soul Shriven usually go insane and turn feral. But not Cadwell. He was already insane before he left Tamriel. Mad as a box of frogs, but completely heartless. You'll see. Cadwell sees things as he wishes them to be. To him, Cold Harbor is a wondrous place. It's his home. And he knows it like the back of his hand. He's usually down by the river. Let's go find him.
One fine day in the middle of the night, two dead kings got up to fight. Back to back, they...
Hello, what's this? Out for a stroll, then? Lovely day for it. Sir Cadwell, yes, indeed, a pleasure. And fair Lyris, good to see you, my dear. How are you, then?
Oh, dear, well, that is inconvenient, isn't it?
Tell you what, I happen to know another way in, much more of a scenic route. Rather a fun little jaunt, actually, full of traps and corpses and nasty beasties filling up the bits in between. Rather cautiously, I expect. Watch your step, hold your nose, and do mind the traps. There'll like as not be a fair dose of running and skull bashing as well. Follow the river. You'll find the door to the Undercroft at the water's end. Once you're inside, stick to the light, and you'll find a ladder that will take you right up to the Prophet straight away. Do give him my best. Best of luck. Do check in now and again, won't you? Well, there's not much to tell, is there? It's the same old pish-tosh, gallant knight, epic quests, rescued maidens. I came to this land when my head was quite unceremoniously separated from my body. Bad luck, that, but you make the best of things. Oh, quite a long time. In fact, I wouldn't be a bit surprised if I was the oldest of the Soulshriven, of those who didn't go feral, that is. I know every tunnel and path, every nook and cranny. The others look up to me, I suppose. Ah, Lyris, girl's as mad as sheer Goris jammies. Heart's in the right place, I suppose. Says she's got to rescue the Prophet to save us all from eternal torment. How an old blind man could do that is quite beyond me. An imperial gentleman. Apparently he was once a powerful mage, but the years haven't been kind. Lyris says he knows of a path back to Tamriel. I rather think that if one existed, I'd have found it by now. I hadn't actually given it much thought. Anything's possible, I suppose. Truth is, I've been here so long, this place feels like home. But a good uprising now and again is a pleasant diversion, so where's the harm, eh?
Cadwell seems to think this Undercroft is a delightful place. Probably means it's a death trap. Better be careful. The sooner you get that door open, the sooner we can get out of here. Part where you bleed to death.
Thank you.
fine day in the middle of the night.
Hello, what's... Sir, can... Best of luck. Do check in now and again. I hadn't actually given it... Well, oh, quite... Lyric.
Caldwell seems to think this undercraft is a delightful...
Get that door open, the sooner we can get out of here. Name again. Prophet's cage should be just ahead. Quickly now, we haven't much time. All right. Good news is we made it here in one piece, and the Prophet looks unharmed. Now the bad news. It's going to be up to you to keep him safe and get him back to Tamriel. I'm not going with you. There's a trick to opening the cell. The only way for a prisoner to leave is for another living soul to take their place. I need to swap places with the Prophet. Believe me, I wish there was, but I don't see anyone else here with a beating heart, do you? If Molag Bal isn't stopped, he'll destroy everyone and everything we've ever loved. Once it's done, get moving. The Prophet will know where to go, but he'll need your eyes and your protection.
freedom! I remember this feeling. It will be fleeting, though, if Molag Bal has his way. Thank the Divines you are safe. There is that, at least. Lyra sacrificed everything that we might go free. Her sacrifice must not be in vain. I wish that were possible, but I promise you, once we escape Cold Harbor, we will find a way to rescue her together, Vestige. That is the name I have given you. You are but a trace of your former self, a soulless one, an empty vessel that longs to be filled. It is as the scrolls foretold, but not exactly as I imagined. That is what I've come to be called. My true name is lost, even to me. Years of torment have taken their toll. Quickly now, we must make haste to the anchor. The anchors are Daedric machines of the darkest magic. Their chains bind our world and pull it towards Cold Harbor. I can use one of these anchors to return us to Tamriel, but you must lead me to it. Up the stairs, quickly! We must get to the anchor mooring! Mooring.
The mortal thinks it can defy me. Futile. Soon your world will be in my chains.
Protect you. This portal is high above us. I will prepare a spell to lift us to it. But first, you must reattune yourself to Nan in order to regain your physical form. To do this, you will need a sky shard. A shard of ethereal magicka that carries the essence of Nan. Some link them to Lorcan, the missing god of creation. If you collect and absorb its power, it should restore your corporeal form. I will summon one of these shards for you to absorb. Shard of Aetherius, fall upon us now and anoint us with your blessing. There, quickly, collect the sky shard. Great Akatosh, dragon god of time, I require your strength. Let the way be opened. Let these wandering souls return home. Let the will of Molag Bal be denied! Hurry! We must go now!
Thank you.
vestige awakens once again. Come here, we must speak. As I feared, we arrived in different locations. I am in a city near the sea, in a land of eternal spring. The air smells of the ocean and of markets and gardens. It matters not. You have awakened once again, and we must set you on your path. Days, weeks, I cannot tell. The voids between worlds disrupted all sense of time and space. I know only that you were deposited into the sea, and some charitable soul fished you out and brought you to dry land. I'm afraid you will have to decide that for yourself. I must focus on searching for a way to repay Lyris's bold sacrifice. I cannot simply abandon her to the wrath of Molag Bal. I cannot foresee that, not yet. But we will meet again. There is still much we need to accomplish. Be wary, Vestige. Our very plane of existence is in peril. The threat of Molag Bal looms across all Tamriel, and chaos spreads in its shadow. Danger roams the land and will assume many forms. Do not let it catch you off guard. You must find your own path, but perhaps there is a reason for the place in which you find yourself. Explore, search for a cause to lend your hand. Join with others. You might even seek out those who rescued you from the sea. The choice is yours. Indeed, I sense that even now, there are good people near you who face grave danger. They need your assistance, should you be willing to give it. To thwart the will of Molag Bal, we must skirmish with evil wherever it rears its head. We do not face these troubled times alone. Many shall rise up to fight this tide of darkness. Wherever you go, you will encounter others who share your courage and valor. Help them if you can, and enlist their aid if you have need of it. You were dragged ashore on an island beach, but I sense that you are now aboard a ship in port. Go ashore and seek out the captain of the vessel. Perhaps he or she can point you toward the charitable spirit who was responsible for your rescue. Be wary, Vestige. Our very plane of...
our next run, I'm going to volunteer for the Crow's Nest. Tired of stinking cargo, stinking crewmates, stinking captains. Ah!
This one can't stand the grog in Volkelgard. Can't wait to get back on the water.
Water looks different in every harbor. Love the shallows here.
Don't know how Joan and Jode have touched you, but this one feels their pull even now.
Coming in. Matat will spend this evening thanking Jode and Joan. They allowed us this passage.
You're no sailor. I can tell by the smell.
That kind of storm. Damn it, Ifri. Why do you have to go and be like that?
Huh?
You're awake! I was worried you'd never wake up. You slept all the way from Canarthi's roost, right through the hurricane. You don't remember? A Khajiit named Razumdar fished you out of the ocean. He paid me a small fortune to bring you here. We barely made it out of Canarthi's roost before the hurricane hit. He was headed to Eagle Strand, an old fort on Canarthi's roost. My ship won't return there for some time, but a bosun on the far dock can take you. Look for Sugar Claws.
You're no sailor.
Have you ever tasted moon sugar rum? This one's not sharing.
Hail.
Water looks different in every...
Yes? I don't recognize you. Please go. My wines are available only by appointment.
Welcome to Volkelgard. What can this one procure for you?
Fresh flavors, exotic spices,
of course.
We provisioners practice the art of cooking and brewing. Good food requires the best ingredients. We gather fresh meat and produce from crates, barrels, and the like. If we're lucky, we'll also find recipes in chests, trunks, and desks. Once we've copied the recipe down and acquired the necessary ingredients, that's when the real fun begins. Cooking pots and rotisseries can be found all over. You only need to find one, select a recipe, and then indulge in the simple joy of cooking. Ah, don't forget drink. Hearty meals will fill your belly, increasing your general well-being, both body and soul. Strong drink can stimulate the humors, allowing you to recover more quickly. If you're lucky, you might find a recipe that does both.
Many visitors, so little time.
Fair day, visitor. I'm Astania, watch captain. I'll need you to state your name for the record. Extra precautions with Queen Irene in town. You understand. I'll just write that down. By order of the 1st Oridon Marines, your presence in Valkelgard has been registered. Do your best to stay out of trouble and out of the way. Fare you well. Help?
No, I don't think so.
Actually, my guardsmen are all tied up right now. If you're up to it, perhaps you could look into some things for me. Good. I want you to speak with two members of the Queen's Court, Advisor Norian and Steward Aminwe. They await assistance from the guard, hands I can't spare just now. Who do you want to speak to first? I see you prioritize well. You'll find him at a warehouse west of here. Be sure to tell him that I sent you. Once you've finished with both of them, report back to me on the town's upper level. Well, what are you waiting for? You hit your head recently. The Queen leads the old Mary Dominion. She had some kind of wild time away from court a few years back, but now she's returned to reclaim her birthright, lead the Alliance. Off gallivanting across Tamriel? Who knows? Who cares? I wish I could just quit my job and come back to it when I get bored. Probably talking up the unity of the Dominion. Not all of us are fans of being united with our feral little cousins and furry friends. Queen Irene's personal guard. They're led by Battle Reeve Urselmo, one of the most decorated warriors in the Dominion. No, I'm captain of the city guards here. The Marines are the right arm of the Queen. My duty is to the city.
Sometimes this one likes to sit and watch the sun.
Thank you.
I'm busy here. Away with you. In that case, you'll do nicely. My servant followed a burglar to this warehouse. The ignorant knave stole a set of marine deployment plans for the Queen's upcoming speech. Well, I'm sure I wouldn't know. I'm no burglar. In any case, we can't let those plans escape. They could be used to bypass the Queen's security, and we wouldn't want that.
Please, I did just as you asked.
Yes. Yes, you did.
Well, did you find the plans? Oh, a pity. Keep the plans. You can give them to the captain next time you see her. In the meantime, I must attend to the Queen. Some kind of criminal feud, I'm sure. Now then, if you have some other task, you should be about it. Do I look like a steward's assistant? Do you take me for a commoner? No. But yes, I happen to know where she is. East warehouse, just north of the docks. You can go now.
This one can relate. Zitana still waits for word from Matisse. So much work for one thing.
I'm sorry, I can't help you right now. I'm very busy and there's a lot to do. Oh, all right then. What was it? Right, the supplies. Two of my cooks took deathly ill right in the middle of preparing the Queen's feast. I suspect sabotage. I want to be sure all of our food supplies are safe. I'm not upset, not at all. I'll examine the supplies in here. You go to the warehouse next door, make sure everything is fresh, and there's nothing out of place.
Hold it right there.
Did you find anything? Thank the stars! You found the problem. Hold on to that. The captain will want to see it. A uniform? Must have been a cut purse. They're always hanging around the docks waiting to steal away with some cargo. Be careful around here.
Hail!
What you found.
Good, good. Look, I hate to rush you, but I have another task for you. One of my men, Heldil, has cornered a thug nearby. We need to talk to this lowborn scum. We've no time for this. He's involved in a plot against the Queen, that's all I can say. We need someone like you to get to him. He refuses to speak with a member of the guard. Just hold it for the moment. Heldil is just up the stairs here, house on the right. Get going. Remember, the Queen's service.
Hello there.
Kindly step back. We have a situation here. Help from the captain. Excellent. Inside, we've cornered a dangerous mer. He's wanted by the Crown, has valuable information, and threatens to kill himself every time we approach the door. I need him alive. Just get in there and get him talking. Don't listen to what he says. He's half crazed. You get him talking, we move in behind you. Got it?
Get back! One step closer, and I'll cut my throat!
Why should I trust you?
Fine. Fine. Just don't try anything. Get in here.
You're no guard. Thank the stars! Quickly, we don't have much time. They're coming. I know you're just a distraction. Listen closely. Captain Estania is corrupt. She's a member of a group called the Veiled Heritants. Veiled Heritants. They're planning an assassination attempt on the Queen at the temple. They bribed members of her staff to get the speech moved here, where they can have the captain in their pocket. No. Only what I've seen and heard. Please, you must warn the Queen. She's in grave danger, and the guards here. Oh no.
Good work, citizen.
Traitors.
Scum. Shut your mouth. You're under arrest.
I live only to serve the Queen.
Sure you do. Baritale?
With pleasure.
Good work. Don't worry. He'll receive a fair trial. The captain is always very even-handed in her pronouncements. Good call. We'll see that this man is taken to a cell. With respect, of course. I have to admit I'm impressed. Cool like the scales of Auriel you are. Good luck with the captain. She sent word. She's moved to the Queen. That'll be at the manor house. Stars guide your steps now.
Nice.
guard!
A common criminal.
Trinamek, guard your heart, traveler. May he...
So much to do, so little time.
Hold!
I must speak with you.
Ah, my errand runner. So good to see you again.
Stop right there. On my authority as captain, you're under arrest, under suspicion of conspiracy to regicide. What's that in your pack? Deployment plans for the Marines at the temple. And do I smell the taint of poison on the air? These are the...
Azumdar's new friend is awake. How do you feel, new friend? It is as this one said. Razumdar is your new friend. But then, this one's friends call him Raz. You may have noticed your last new friend, Fezian. He lies dead on the ground behind you. The captain happened. Fezian and Raz worked together as agents of the Queen. Fezian was not willing to give up secrets, and so now Fezian is dead. Raz needs a partner now. So yes, you will soon be free. For a price. You must warn the Queen and her battle reeve. The captain will attempt to murder the Queen at the temple. You must get past the captain's men. Seek out another of our lady's agents, Eshaba. She stands watch in the marketplace, peddling her wares. Ask her for a souvenir of the first Marines, and she will set you on your path. Now, out of here! Save the Queen! You have questions, new friend? You have this one's apologies. He was looking for Fezian. It is a happy accident for us both that you could be saved. You escaped the cell. And Razumdar's new plan to warn the Queen moves forward. It is somewhat embarrassing, but this one's face is known to some of the royal court. If Razumdar were to approach, they would know something is amiss. You, a new face in a Marine's uniform, they would suspect nothing. Is there anything else this one can convey? Yes, as did Fezian. He told you true. We are the eyes of the Queen. We are few, and we stick to the shadows. But we have the honor of being the Queen's most trusted agents. The battle reeve is fiercely loyal. He believes his Marines are immune to manipulation, like newly forged steel blades. But Razumdar knows better than most how quickly stains can set in. They don't think we need the Dominion to survive. They think the Queen is making a mistake, elevating the Bosmer and Khajiit to be equals with the High Elves. Racists, isolationists, and general idiots.
You know... never mind.
Greetings. Hello there.
Esheba has just about anything you could want. So, what can she get you? Is that so? Don't be shy. What do you need? Ah, yes. Esheba has that. The perfect thing to suit your needs. But are you certain? This souvenir comes with certain expectations. A wise purchase, then. Very beneficial. Please take it from the chest here, just behind me. If you see our mutual friend again, be sure to give him this one's best.
These double shifts are killing me.
Oh yes, I've got an in with the foreman. Getting some for a great price.
Bah! Damn you, tally and your petty.
Explain yourself. What are you doing here? Razumdar. Yes, I know the name. You haven't answered my question, though. We've taken every precaution. The whole area is locked down. Watch Captain Estonia assured me. The guard, Captain? Absurd!
A moment, Aselmo. I would hear what this one has to say.
Queen Irene. I fear for your safety. Please disregard what was said just...
Razumdar was mentioned. He acts on my behalf. If you won't investigate, I will.
Apologies, my queen. As you will. You are a capable woman. But you must be wary. You, come with me. We'll investigate the temple together. What's happened here?
You. I'm sorry. I was wrong. I tried to stop them. Watch out. On the balcony. It's Estonia. It's a trap.
Selmo. I see you've met my latest toy.
Estonia? Traitor! Come down here and face me!
Our queen has betrayed us. I wanted her head. I'll settle for yours. Kill them!
Estonia.
It's not over yet, Battleweed. Heritance will see to that.
The Dominion will last long after your corpse cools. Now come down here and face your death.
I'll have to take care of you myself.
Need to report back to the Queen. Let's get out of here.
Well, what did my protectors find? Estonia, I can't believe it. No doubt Selmo will triple his watch. She truly was an agent of the Veiled Heritance.
Betrayal. She turns against her people after years of service, and she spoke of my betrayal? She obviously could not be trusted. But you have proven your worth. The Marines are blunt instruments. A queen must have a lighter touch. You've met Razumdar first in the eyes of the queen. Would you join him? Become an elite agent for the good of the Dominion? Excellent. By what power I hold, I name you an agent in my employ. You are now an Eye of the Queen, bonded to my service. Auriel keep you safe, and Zarxis guard your words. Now to look to larger things. I must cement my position and continue my tour of the Isle. I must make for the ancient site known as Tanzelwil. Normally, a new monarch communes quietly with the dead. We're supposed to show willingness to heed the wisdom of our ancestors. As you saw today, my reign so far has been anything but normal. I worry there will be complications, and the presence of my newest eye would assuage that worry. Make your way to Tanzelwil at your own pace. Seek out my entourage when you arrive. They'll be able to direct you to me. And good luck to us both on the road. As you wish. I'm not sure I know much more than you at this point. I wish I could say yes. Astania got closer than anyone else has. Subverting a watch captain. I can't believe they'd be so bold. An end to the Dominion. They want me to step down, to appoint their own regent, for everyone not of high elven descent to leave the Somerset Isles. The list goes on and on. They're racists, high elven supremacists with no understanding of the real world, short-sighted misanthropes with delusions of grandeur, bastard throwbacks that should crawl back beneath their rock. Oh, thank Auriel. Someone who's not too blinded by my crown to ask a real question. Apologies. Of course I'd be happy to chat. What would you like to know? My father, King Hiddelith of Eleanor, passed on to Aetherius. He was a good man, as is my brother, Naemon. I returned to take my father's place because my lifetime of experience has prepared me, honed me to be the ruler we need. Have you heard some of the rumors? My exploits have been greatly exaggerated, I can assure you. Except the story about the bear. That one's true. To be blunt, the Altmer are too few. Together with the Wood Elves and Khajiit, we have the iron will, the strength of arms, and the depth of character to solve the problems facing Tamriel. I do. I spent years traveling the face of Nern. The alliance we've forged is the strongest in the world. I spent months working with the Main and the Tree Thanes to create this dominion of ours. I'm very proud of it. No. Raz and I met while I was traveling many years ago. We met in Wayrest. Or was it Whiterun? Something with a W. The story's a long one and involves a drunken schoolmarm and a purple velvet dress.
Hello?
You've saved the Queen. What else can I say? Well done! Very well done!
Why, I have the pleasure of being the High Kinlord of Firsthold. The name's Rilis, the 13th. My family has ruled the northern tip of Auradon almost as long as Ultima have lived on the island.